New tonight, a new approach giving criminals a second chance.
Supporters say it would save you money and save space in Nebraska's overcrowded prisons.
I-Team investigator Ryan Luby tonight on hopes for a privately funded self-help program, one that has roots in California.
When you think of people who've done bad things, bars, walls, and barbed wire come to mind, a place to pay for mistakes when you meet someone like Terrell Taylor.
I guess I just wanted more, so I got involved with the streets.
You learn that he spent 5 years in a place like that for selling crack cocaine. You also learn that once he got out, his ability to start over wasn't easy.
With that stigma of being a felon, it's difficult to get employment.
And that's because a lot of employers don't like to hire anyone who's been behind bars, particularly a convicted felon. So you can imagine what happens.
Just becomes a revolving door.
Community leader Doug Gray says many of those felons, especially those involved with drugs, get caught again and again. So that's why he and others with a newly found group called Bootstraps and Beyond have looked to California for the solution.
Is this the same public that you would have been robbing?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Specifically, a nonprofit called the Delancey Street Foundation has periodically been in the news since the mid-1970s.
They bring people in that society has pretty much thrown away.
Delancey Street is so unique because it has its own businesses, all run by convicted felons who live on site as a court-ordered alternative to prison. They handle a restaurant, an auto mechanic shop, a moving company, just to name a few.
One of the great things about Delancey Street is it pays for itself. In the long run.
State Senator Amanda McGill says that's because those businesses are so successful. Not only do they keep Delancey Street afloat, but they train the 500 or so felons who are in the program at any given time important life skills that they may not have had before. At the same time, the program forces the felons to learn from one another to develop healthier habits that will keep them out of jail. A success rate, she says, of an incredible 80%.
One of the criticisms of this program is it's very tough love. It is pull yourself up by your bootstraps.
She says that's what Bootstraps and Beyond here in Nebraska wants to emulate in the next few years. And since it wouldn't cost taxpayers a dime, she hopes it works. So does Doug Gray.
This, I think, is a good start.
And so does Terrell Taylor, a man who'd embrace an alternative to the bars and walls, something that would give convicted criminals a better second chance. Ryan Luby, KETV News, Watch 7.
Bootstraps and Beyond would build a facility through donations. Now, Ryan also contacted Bob Houston, director of Nebraska's Department of Corrections. He wouldn't go on camera, but says he embraces Bootstraps and Beyond and will help the group anyway.